With Nags. This is another video in premium per user series. One of the features in this licensing is paginated reports. Let us try to check it out. What is paginated reports and what are the advantages when we go to paginated reports and when we should avoid paginated reports? What is the difference between Power BI desktop and paginated? Let's check it out in this video. If you are new to this channel, hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon for notifications. So you will avail all this feature along with pro users when you have a Power BI premium per user. That is, premium per users licensing will get all these benefits, whereas pro users will not get. All other features are explained in my previous video. If you have missed it, just go and watch in this premium per user series. Now our focus on paginated reports, which is basically, it's not a new reporting tool, whereas it exists for long with the name of SSRS. In Microsoft Business Intelligence world, SSRS is so famous, and in order to merge this into a single platform like Power BI, already Power BI has a reporting tool like self-servicing BI tool, whereas some of the features which are not fitting into the Power BI. For that, we have SSRS in place. Merging these two will give you more benefit. So some of the things you cannot achieve in Power BI desktop can be achieved in paginated reports, right? What are those? Let us check it out in this video. Now, paginated reports have their own design tool. That is what you need to understand. So in Power BI desktop, you cannot create your paginated reports. That is point number one. And it does not have underlying data model. So you may think like you have a very good data model, and some reports you can build in Power BI desktop. Some of the things you can go for paginated reports. That is not possible because Power BI paginated reports does not use any data model. No drag and drop for creating the reports. There is drag and drop, but you need to configure manually and you need to format it. Let us try to check it out once I do some small demo. Another limitation is like once you deploy your paginated reports, either paginated reports or reports created by Power BI desktop can be deployed in Power BI services. And the paginated reports are not or cannot be pinned into Power BI dashboards, right? So that is one of the limitations. There is no shared data sources and shared data sets in paginated reports. Okay, what is the key difference when to use the paginated reports? It's like mostly the Power BI desktop creates a self-servicing BI, which creates a high-level graphical interface. I mean, graphs like a pie chart, bar chart, cards to display the high-level information. But sometimes it is not suitable for the table level information, where detail level information based on different parameters, you need to create different pages of reports. Assume like for each customer, you want to generate some invoice or any other reports. Assume you are running a school, and for each student, you need to generate some progress report that should be automated. For each student, you need to create a single page that should be automated. So these type of functionalities are missing in Power BI desktop reports. So that is why people will go for paginated reports. Not only for that, there are other advantages. For printing purposes, you have a pixel perfect PDF reports, then you will go for paginated reports. Let us try to launch paginated reports and see how it is different from Power BI desktop. So the thing is like you can either download it from here, downloads and Power BI paginated reports, BI paginated reports. You can search and get the download link from here. So that is also fine. And I just downloaded and I installed it. You can go with this and you can download it from the links. This is absolutely fine. And once you download the Power BI report builder, you can start typing report builder and you have option over here. I just created a simple report. Like how you can create a report, it's like just drag and drop certain items. Like over here, let me delete this one. You can go to insert once you create a data set, and you can have all these options. Like you can have a table and list of objects and charts and gauge, map, data bars, indicators, text, images. All this, most of the things are you may see it in the Power BI desktop itself, but this is specific to this case. So this is typically a matrix table, and now you can create one chart, insert a chart. Now I will want to show like online or offline order, so let us choose this one. Then you can choose what has to be seen over here. Like, so I want to see the quantity here and by product, online or offline, right? Order type name. Let us go by this. Once you click on it, you can see here, this is the chart, but you cannot see the results immediately. You can add the chart title, you can add the typings, I mean headings here. Then similarly, I've created this matrix report. Once you run this one, you can see the reports over here. This is the one you can see after creating the report. Unlike Power BI desktop, where you will get the immediate reports, you need to run it, then see the results over here. So you can do a formatting, everything over here, right clicking on it. You can change the background for this. Let us try to check some properties for this text box. And you can see some of the properties that you can change it here. Alignment, font, or any other things you can change it here. Instead of this, I want a red color. So such properties you can change always. Then you can see you can see here some of the properties like background. I've seen somewhere here. Yeah. Let us go for mild color. Then just go and check it out. So this is how it will populate, right? So you put only this column. So depends upon the number of locations, it has changed, right? So these are the things you can do it here, similar to this. So what is it? So basically, it is meant for reporting by page by page, and that is what a paginated report. You can have a parameters you can choose from here, and one of the example I want to show is like I can change this report to print for this table by page based on the location. For that, let me add location here. Sorry, not the location. I put by location here, is it? So, or okay, I will do online order or online offline order on top of this. Then clicking on it, group properties, I can say page break. You break the page based on this group, right? Also start at the start of the group, something like that. When you press it, when you click on it, okay. Like online shop is one option, and next page it will go to online order, right? So on shop is one of the item and online order is second page. It moved to the second page. That is how you can able to control different pages. As I said before, if you have multiple students in your you are running a school, you want to generate a report for different students, you can split by the page. You can customize in number of pages. This page you can have this many rows, in another page you can go to another rows. So these kind of adjustment you can make. That is what a paginated report is meant for. So if your requirement is based on such a things like customizable pixel perfect reports, you can go for it. There are other options we are going to explore, as I'm going to demonstrate the complete playlist how to start from the beginning. Let us try to check deep in our paginated reports playlist. Now let me try to deploy this report. Now you can publish through your Power BI services. So I've logged in, and in once you deploy it in the Power BI services, you should have a premium workspace capacity. Once you deploy it, you can go and check it out. It will work properly. Only thing is like you need to configure the gateway properly. The sales workspace, this is not a premium per user. You cannot deploy it here. Once you deploy, it will not allow, since it is not under premium. And you need to deploy it in your premium per user workspace or premium per capacity workspace. This is what about introduction about the paginated reports. We will see more about how to create from the scratch and what are the things you can do it in paginated reports in our upcoming videos. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up button and comment below for queries. Do remember that data is your asset.